Revelation 13, verse 17 says, "And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name." Facial recognition technology is capable of matching a human face from a digital image. It sounds helpful, but to whom? To the individual? To the government? In this TikTok video, a young Chinese woman complains that she can't get food. She has failed the facial recognition test and will now have to get food from a relative. What will it be like when you have to pass a facial recognition test to make a simple purchase, like to buy lunch or a dinner? Just look at this video.
So the latest in this dystopian outrage that is now all of China, apparently, is I once again cannot buy food. A couple days ago, my uncle and my cousin helped me get a cell phone that is linked to a Chinese bank card so that I could buy anything. But now, apparently, it has been flagged for some reason, and I have to pass facial recognition identity verification, which is insane, because all I want to do is just spend my gift card balance on this debit card. I can't believe I'm doing this. I have to open my mouth. Oh my God. Terrifying. And of course, because it was my cousin who set this up for me, I did not pass verification. I guess it's a good thing that the Chinese app is not racist. But now, I once again can't buy anything.
If you think we haven't come to that point yet, take a look at this video. Joan Meyer, the 98-year-old co-owner of the Marion County, Kansas Record, died the day after law enforcement raided her home. Her son believes the stress of the raid on her home and the newsroom was a contributing factor to her death. Do you think this police raid on the home of a 98-year-old woman might have been stressful? Do you think it was totally wrong and uncalled for? You be the judge. Look at the video.
Calling Eric Meyer.
Don't you touch any of that stuff.
Ma'am,
you're wasting your breath. This is my house.
I know. You're wasting your breath. Ma'am, we'll be out of here pretty quick.
Get them out of here. They're here. Police chief, you're the chief. Oh God, yeah. You're Pat Patrick. Get up, stand outside. You can stand outside that door and still see them. I don't want you in my house. What's he doing over there going through the papers?
How many computers do you have in the house, man?
I'm not going to tell you. Get out of my way.
It's all right.
I want to see what they're doing.
Well, they're working.
I don't care what they're doing.
So you can go on through if you want.
What are you doing? Those are personal papers.
Ma'am, those aren't papers. They're electronic devices, which is what the judge said that we're supposed to take. Okay?
You people.
Now to connect this with the previously shown video of the lady who couldn't get food because she failed the facial recognition test. Supposing law enforcement in Marion County, Kansas, also was in control of food distribution, health care, and public utilities. And supposing law enforcement used facial recognition technology to provide essential services, does anyone care to argue that corrupt law enforcement would not punish its adversaries by cutting off essential services? We can control you. We can starve you. We can delete you. The World Economic Forum, BlackRock, and our own woke government wants us to surrender U.S. sovereignty, censor speech, and turn the world into a communist utopia. The only problem, a communist utopia is a communist hell. Wherever communism has appeared, it has destroyed the nation. Look at China. Cuba, Venezuela. Nicolae Ceausescu, the communist leader in Romania, met his end when the people of Romania rose up and put an end to his tyranny. What a wonderful, wonderful thing to do. Now, there is some good news in all of this. Consumer backlash against woke ideology. In the short period since Anheuser-Busch's marketing blunder, the company has lost billions of dollars in revenue. The heir to the Anheuser-Busch company has offered to buy back his family's old company from its parent company. Billy Bush wants to, quote, make that brand great again. Billy Bush went on to slam the current owners for hiring the woke marketing students that led to the current Bud Light debacle. Indeed, go woke and go broke. Even the Southern-style restaurant chain Cracker Barrel stepped into wokeism recently by its rainbow rocking chairs honoring Pride Month. The company promoted a photo of a rocking chair with each wood slat painted a different color of the rainbow in a nod to the Pride flag. The caption read, "Everyone is always welcome at our table and our rainbow rocker." You know, they missed the point. This is not about welcoming people at your table. It's about endorsing an aggressive, in-your-face movement that is totalitarian in every way, totally un-American. It belongs in Nazi Germany, not in the United States. What should the Christian response be? Well, may I suggest Romans 12:2? And be not conformed to the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.